this is the best day of your life. You say, how can you say that? Because God gave me a special word for you. And it's from 1 Corinthians 2:16. It says, but we have the mind of Christ. I said that early this morning. I have the mind of Christ. So the mind of Christ is going to work for good through this day. And we have a guest that I'm going to tell you will help you know in to have the mind of Christ. Mm-hmm. And Laura Harris-Smith, you've been with us before.
Yes.
We just love you. So does our audience. But you have a brand new book, The 30-Day Faith Detox. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now tell us just some things and maybe review quickly your story of how you got into this. But oh, the miracles that have come out of this for you and for all of you too. This is key for you today, the mind of Christ for you.
Oh, well, thank you, Marilyn. Thank you for having me here, Sarah. I've lived this. I am a go-getter. I have a big, huge family and a, you know, huge life, the writing and the speaking, and we pastor a church, Eastgate Creative Christian Fellowship in Nashville, and that alone is, you know, I mean, you have congregants to care for, and so yes, I was leading a big king-size life with very little sleep. I was not resting like I should. And yes, I would put on a pot of coffee at midnight and get a second creative wind and keep working till 2 and 3 and then get up and homeschool my kids the next day. And did it fairly well. And then I got into my mid, late 40s and it wasn't going to happen anymore. My body was running out of adrenaline, which fuels you and gives you energy. And tests revealed that I was on the brink of adrenal failure. It's interesting because it has been stated John F. Kennedy had he was on the brink of adrenal failure as well, and had he not been assassinated, he would have been dead within a year. And I was told, make changes or die. So I had to learn the secrets of using food for medicine because I had so many organs messing up, and stage 4 of adrenal fatigue and or adrenal burnout is when all of your organs shut down. And I was told I was in stage 3. So my body could not have even handled multiple prescription medications. I had to use the things God had created on the third day of creation. So through what I learned, being on bed rest and, you know, being in the middle of a book contract anyway, I decided that I owed it to my readers to go back to school, learn about nutrition, and I became a nutritionist. I, 6 months later, was up and back to my normal life, resting this time. And I became a nutritionist, and now I want to pass along to others secrets to divine health. Because as we were saying before, there's a difference in healing and divine health. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we gave God less crisis intervention prayers to answer, and we just did what He told us to do with our bodies?
And I love the book for that reason, don't you?
Yeah, and one of the things I love about it is just the practical nature. Walking through various food, and you have recipes in here that are super fun, like really fun and very appealing, of course. But I also like that you don't just deal, I like that it's body, soul, spirit. Yeah. I like that we address these things in a cohesive, holistic way and not just little pieces and parts, because that's what we are. We're a unified entity.
Yeah.
So our body affects our soul, affects our body, our spirit, that's all intertwined.
That's right.
So like case in point, in section 3, social influence toxins. That's one of the things, and I just like flip to a random chapter. And you talk through this spiritual emphasis, emotions associated with these toxins, and bodily systems detoxed. So help us with, what does that look like?
Well, let me just first say that the way I broke the 30 days down into was that I began to notice at the altar when people would come to prayer, for prayer at the altar at Eastgate, they would, all of their prayer requests fell into one of these 5 categories. And it was either their social influences, things going on in the world around them, media, social media, all of that, how it impacts us, their finances, their health, their relationships, or just their personal identity. What does God want me to do with my life? Or why are my prayers not answered? So I divide the 30 days into these 5 sections, and we spend 6 days on your relationships, 6 days on your social influences, 6 days on your, you know, and on and on and on. And yes, what I have found is that you cannot segregate the 3. We all know we're made of 3 parts, but if you go back to the Garden of Eden and you see the Trinity already hard at work, you know, let us make man in our image That's proof right there. Because
right.
God is three. And if we're made in His image, we are three and we can't segregate them. We must take care of all three. So that's the approach of the book. Healing your faith, getting your relationship with God where it should be based on body, mind, and spirit. Total temple health.
All right. Wait. I have a question. Because here's the deal. Somebody's watching and they're going to say, healing your faith. What makes you think your faith needs healing? Because like legitimately, that's like, that sounds weird.
Have you ever, honestly, I have been praying for a person before and I was praying for the miracle and all of a sudden the Lord said, no, you need to pray for their faith to be healed. They're out of faith. Like they are so, this chronic illness or this relationship struggle that's been going on for decades, they are at the end of their faith rope. And, you know, without faith, it's impossible to please the Lord. And so we have to come to Him with faith. It's the currency of heaven. It is the thing in, with which we purchase, the cross purchased all, but it is the thing by which we access every good thing for our life. And so I say a person needs healing for their faith when doubt has begun to creep in. We need to put your doubt on a diet. We need to flip that over and have you begin to preach the Word again and not your experience. Because if you go through something and let's say you pray for someone and they're not healed, if you don't get your faith right after that, you're going to start changing your theology around. And instead of preaching what God's Word says, which is to stand on that, you know, healing is the children's bread. If you don't do that, suddenly you're going to wake up one day and not believe that God can heal at all. And so that's what I mean by healing your faith.
And I know people are watching right now. She's like reading your mail. I mean, you're just sitting there like, oh my goodness, I had no idea that my faith has been discouraged or broken or even compromised. We all say the right things, but sometimes our faith and our what's really reality doesn't always match up. And so I want to encourage you to hop on the phone. You feel like your faith is broken, your faith is contaminated, is discouraged, is dysfunctional, is based around experiences and not the Word of God. Hop on the phone, get on the website. We want to pray for you, but also I encourage you as well. This book will really help jumpstart your faith. Because Laura, you said this, this is a book about faith.
It is.
It's not just body. There's great things that happen with the body, but also ground zero, faith.
Yeah.
So walking that through.
Yeah, it is. And so because it includes a nutritional element, there have been all people all over the world who are writing us about this weight loss, but I keep telling them more important than the weight loss is the faith gain. You cannot even be Christian if you don't have faith. You know why? Because it took faith to become a Christian. And this is why the enemy comes after our faith. He knows if he can get our faith, he can take away the very things that are going to help us really testify to the world and allow the supernatural to flow through us. So it is very important that we get our faith in that place where we can hear the Lord and move in His will and begin to access the things, the supernatural things that God has for our lives.
Another question too that I had is it relates to a Harvard study about your thoughts, right? And your food. What's that?
Actually what they say is that the brain is so connected to the stomach that they should be considered one organ system. Now think about this though, when you get stage fright, I know you ladies don't ever get it, but stage fright, you have the thoughts up here, I'm afraid, I'm panicking. You get the feelings in your gut, maybe you're nauseous, some people do worse than that. Or what about having a gut feeling? These idioms that we have, a gut reaction, you know, are because the brain and the stomach are intricately connected. So Harvard is calling it the gut-brain connection. I am proposing that if your brain and your, you know, that whole functioning part of you affects your thoughts or your faith, I'm suggesting that therefore because your faith is greatly influenced by those thoughts, if you think about, you look in Scripture at what our faith, how our faith is connected to our thoughts, if they're proposing that your food and what you eat, they're saying that foods can even cure depressions and help with anxieties. So you've got your food here, you've got your thoughts here. Bible says thoughts and faith are related, so I'm proposing that your food and your faith are related and that you could chemically be propelling yourself towards doubt. It's intangible, and yet on the other hand, it's the miracle of how we are made. Three parts.
That's totally cool.
Isn't that cool?
And I bet you're thinking right now, you're like, wow, that's like, I never thought of those correlations and connections. Mm-hmm. Make sure you hop on the phone, get on the website, grab several copies of this, and of course, we want to pray for you. But you know, Mom, I've seen this in your life, and I've seen how you walk through healthy eating.
Yeah.
And you trained me this way. I mean, we grew up eating all kinds
juicing
of healthy food.
Yeah.
Grew up around a garden. We were talking about that. Rhubarb and strawberries right. and carrots and all. Yeah, right. It was awesome, right?
Right.
And where did you get some of that stuff?
I think early, my mother was health conscious because she had come from a farm. So, you know, she had lots of vegetables. I was born in Texas, so, you know, they grew everything. And I think that helped me. But also, just the mind of Christ. I think this book is the mind of Christ because your spirit, your soul, and your body. And I began to get into the Word before I was a Christian. And then when I became a Christian, man, the Word really came alive. And so I began to feed my spirit. And this book helps you in that spirit part of you. But then it began to affect my mind and my emotions because I began to say what God said. And then I saw my body is very important to Him, extremely important. And so I began to read books on nutrition. And then I wanted my children to, you know, be strong and healthy. You just have them a certain amount of time. And so I wanted them to be involved with health. So that's basically, I know you were raised this way.
That explains
but
so much.
We raised you to sleep, too. Mm-hmm. We saw that you got your sleep and all those good things. But I'm telling you, if you don't get this book, I almost feel sorry for you because it is such a blessing.
Do you need a reset button for your mind, body, and spirit? Wellness expert and certified nutrition counselor Laura Harris-Smith takes you on a 30-day journey that will not only reset and detox your body, but also your mind and spirit. For your gift of $25 or more, we will send you 30-Day Faith Detox, where you'll confront 30 universal faith toxins like doubt, discouragement, and anger, and flush them out. Using ingredients from your own kitchen, you'll get delicious recipes for smoothies, juices, soups, and entrees that cleanse your body, as you also detox your mind and spirit through prayer and meditation on God's Word. We'll also send you Marilyn's Healing Faith Teaching CD. The first step to receiving healing is having faith that the Lord still heals and wants to heal you. In this interactive message, Marilyn shares her personal story of healing and walks you through the steps of how to be healed. We will also include our healing scripture card for easy reference to God's Word on healing. Call or click today for this valuable resource.
So glad that you're watching today with Marilyn and Sarah. And you know, Laura, you said something just in that last little segment that I was like, wait a second, I don't quite get that. And sometimes I'm a little slow on the uptake. So walk us through that Harvard thing again, gut brain.
It's fascinating,
isn't it? Walk us up.
Yeah, so basically science is confirming that there is a link between our food and our thoughts. They're calling it the gut brain connection. So it's saying that so many of the foods that we eat can be affecting our thoughts and giving us depressions and anxieties. And so they're proposing that they should be, the brain and the stomach, digestive tract, should be like one organ system. So I kind of built upon that and said, all right, if there is a gut-brain link and what you eat affects your thoughts, the Bible talks about your thoughts affect your faith. So as a man thinketh in his heart, you know, so is he. And so I started proposing, wow, if there's a link between your food and your thoughts, and the Bible says there's a link between your thoughts and your faith, what if there's a link between your food and your faith? So this is why, and we know that there is, because fasting and removing food boosts your faith. Mm-hmm. So that's the precipice of the book and the 30 days is investing in yourself, investing in your faith, and really turning your life around body, mind, and spirit. That's where you'll see lasting fruit.
You know, along that line, do you remember when Jonathan dipped his staff in the honey?
Ooh.
And that's an interesting contrast because there was, remember Saul said to the whole army, you're not going to eat until we win.
That is a fascinating correlation.
Exactly. Because that kind of speaks to it on a biblical perspective about the food-faith correlation. Because when Jonathan ate that honey, his eyes brightened and they had energy and like positivity and all this stuff because of that. So, I mean, that's something to kind of think about, right?
I love honey. Yes. Get lots of honey in the book.
And really, make sure you hop on the website, get lots of these books. It'll be a super blessing to you. And also, I know that you're watching and you have needs. Some of you watching right now are in critical health situations. You've gotten reports from the doctor that are so discouraging, so disheartening. Some of you watching, you have chronic problems that just seem you can't ever get away from them. We want to pray for you. We want God to come in and really do a supernatural healing in your body from the top to the soles of your body. So hop on the phone, get on the website, and when you do, of course, grab a couple of these books because not only do you want healing, but really the truth of it is we want health.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, we do.
Healing's great, but health,
what is
that difference?
Yeah. Well, I had a man who came to the altar once for prayer and he had digestive issues. And so I prayed and I said, we're going to call down heaven. I'm going to believe you're going to be healed. All right. So we prayed and then I asked him afterwards, so what do you eat? Tell me how you're going to steward this miracle. And his answer to me was trash. He eats trash, you know? And so his miracle, it did not last. He was sick again. He had a myriad of diagnoses. So he writes me a year later, finally at the end of himself, and he says, I'm ready. I'm ready to hear whatever you have to say. The man has lost weight. Mm-hmm. He's in his, late 50s. His testosterone has kicked back in because we provided his body with, you need a little bit of good cholesterol to create hormones. Yeah. So we balanced all of that out. He actually lost a limp in his leg that he'd had for years. He had all kinds of different things wrong with him. And so, yes, you have to start saying, I believe in healing, but I want health. And that requires cooperation. You have to cooperate with God on that.
You know, Sarah, I think it's so interesting. I've been studying all the miracles in the Bible. Mm-hmm. And they're always preceded by an act in the natural. So if you look at Moses, you know, he threw the stick into the water.
Oh, okay.
But then, in a miracle, you get a revelation. Mm-hmm. Well, this is Jehovah Rapha. Mm-hmm. Then you live in the lifestyle. So there are three parts to the miracle.
I'm going to borrow that. That's good.
So the act in the natural can be a food thing.
Right?
Okay. Then you get a revelation of God in it. Mm-hmm. Then you live in the lifestyle of it. And I see it over and over in the Bible. Mm-hmm. So I think what you do here is you give us the act in the natural. Mm. And then what happens? We get a revelation of God in it. Mm-hmm. And then once we get the revelation of God, we got the lifestyle to live in.
It does become a lifestyle. I've had people tell me, you know, they're on day 10 and they're thinking, what am I going to have on day 30 when I get off or whatever? And then they somehow in the middle of it, they get over this hump and they want to make it a lifestyle. And one man who'd lost 25 pounds during it went on to now he is at 44 pounds a month after the detox. It does become a lifestyle when it's revelation.
Yeah. What would you say would be the number one sign for that you need a detox, right?
Well, bodily, if you're replacing your 9 daily, you know, servings recommended allowance of fruits and vegetables with a compromised diet, which we all do, that's number one sign. And then that's going to result in like a loss of health, a gain in weight, cortisol. If you have extra stress in your life, you're going to notice extra belly fat around here. So there are signs. That's probably the number one sign you need a body detox is if you're not eating colorfully and you're showing weight gain or health loss. Number one sign you need an emotional detox is if you're stressed out, you sigh a lot, psychologists call that air hunger. I had a big bad case of it. I was sighing this morning. I was thinking, and I notice it when I do it now. I'm like, what is wrong with me? Okay, I must be a little stressed. I need to just breathe deeply and turn something over to the Lord, you know? So there are signs in our emotions as well that we need to get some toxins out. And then spiritually, I mean, listen, it shows up in our faith. It shows up in the way we talk to God or stop talking to God. And we have to keep that cleansed. Your spirit is the eternal thread that holds your body and your mind together. Mm-hmm. And so it's so important that you keep your spirit detoxified as well.
And that's Proverbs 4:23, guard your heart.
Yes.
I mean,
out of it springs
legitimately
all the issues.
And I've seen that again and again as a pastor's kid, as a pastor's wife. I watch people and their hearts get cold, bitter, angry, unforgiveness, harsh. They get brittle. And that, when that starts, then it's just a downward spiral. And you see things, their relationships get ugly, everything starts to go down the toilet.
That's so true.
So important. So you really need to hop on the phone. And I may have just described some challenges that you're struggling with. Maybe you're struggling with some bitterness. Maybe you've got some unforgiveness. Maybe you've got some disappointment, some unresolved frustration with God. I was reading Job lately, and he absolutely went through a season with that. Yeah. I mean, these are all things that then life sometimes throws you some curveballs. You're like, whoa, I didn't see that coming. We want to pray for you. Hop on the phone, get on the website. We love to pray for you, and we see God do amazing things. God answers. One of the things I love about God is God answers prayers in ways we don't frequently expect. Right? There are so many times I tell God, I want you to do it this way. This is the method. You're supposed to answer it this way.
Yeah.
And then God comes around it in a different way, and you're like, oh, you did answer that. I just didn't expect it in that method.
Oh, yeah.
So I think, and I really believe that in many respects, that's the same way with this book.
You know what? Had God just answered my prayer for a miracle, because, you know, miracles and healing are different. They're listed as two separate gifts of the Spirit in 1 Corinthians 12. If he had done that miracle, this never would have existed. And now we've got over, so the book's 3 months old, and we've got over 12,000 people who are doing their detox so far. Mm-hmm. We're already in a second printing. And so ministry came out of my mess, you know? So they are opportunities if we'll cooperate with God and move with what he's doing, not what we originally want. It'll bless a lot of people.
Yeah.
I think, Sarah, too, that we have to realize God doesn't wear a watch. And I think, you know, well, I want to snap out of this overnight. You know, I want to have energy. I don't want to be depressed. But really, it is a process so many times. So I've had miracles of healing. Appreciate it. No end. But also, I've had God with the process thing. And so I want to encourage you. This helps you with process. And I love this in your book, how you have different colored vegetables that do different things.
Yep.
You know, I never knew that. I thought, oh, this book has wonderful revelation. You mean yellow vegetables do this, red do this? And so it helped me to see what helps what. You know, you say, well, how is this? And remember the process. Well, I'd like to snap out of this and 12 minutes or, you know, 12 hours. But if we will go through the process, I'm telling you, the results are out of this world. So please call in, you know, with your prayer requests. Please call in. And really, you know, getting this book and getting it into the hands of others, folks, we got to have a process most of the time to see the miracles we'd like to see in our lives. God bless you today.
Do you need a reset button for your mind, body, and spirit? Wellness expert and certified nutrition counselor Laura Harris-Smith takes you on a 30-day journey that will not only reset and detox your body, but also your mind and spirit. For your gift of $25 or more, we will send you 30-Day Faith Detox, where you'll confront 30 universal faith toxins like doubt, discouragement, and anger, and flush them out. Using ingredients from your own kitchen, you'll get delicious recipes for smoothies, juices, soups, and entrees that cleanse your body, as you also detox your mind and spirit through prayer and meditation on God's Word. We'll also send you Marilyn's Healing Faith Teaching CD. The first step to receiving healing is having faith that the Lord still heals. heals and wants to heal you. In this interactive message, Marilyn shares her personal story of healing and walks you through the steps of how to be healed. We will also include our healing scripture card for easy reference to God's word on healing. Call or click today for this valuable resource.
We're so glad to have our guest with us today, Laura, and you know, many of the people watching today, would you please pray for our audience? Because so many of them have health issues, their faith, they're discouraged because of faith stuff has happened, they've got some emotional struggles, and you praying for them would be just invaluable.
Yeah, I've been there. I would love to. Well, I just want to encourage you, if you are someone who has little energy, I want to just tell you, I'm sitting next to someone who has tons of energy in her 80s because she takes care of herself, body, mind, and spirit. And I, in my 50s now, I feel better than I did in my 20s because I've learned to steward my body and my mind and my spirit the way God intended. So I want to pray for you to have supernatural help today, but that also that God would begin to add His super to your natural, and that the decisions that you make, body, mind, and spirit, would begin to change you from the inside out. So, Father, I thank you for my friend here today, and I thank you that no matter what their issue is in their body, even if it's chronic, they are going to be given secrets by you to use wellness to counteract illness and to resolve illness in their life. Father, thank you that their emotions are going to be whole. Someone is really struggling with discouragement, even despair, even to the point of wanting to take your own life, and the Lord says, I have a new start for you. That's not a part of your future, and you are going to live long and live strong. And for your spirit, that you would be powerful in the spirit and be the person of faith that you want to be. So I just speak over you, 1 Thessalonians 5:23, that you would remain blameless, body, soul, and spirit at the coming of our Lord Jesus, and that He would give you every key that you need to be able to remain healthy, body, mind, and spirit. God bless you, friend.
Thank you for watching our YouTube channel.
We are so thrilled that we get to minister to you on YouTube. So, of course, you got to hit the subscribe button because we want to continue to get to connect and at your convenience. That's one of the things I love about YouTube is you can watch at your own convenience. And when you subscribe, then you get all the latest and the greatest. So make sure you hit that and stay connected with us. More importantly, God wants to minister and speak to you through this wonderful opportunity. So thanks again and make sure you subscribe.